Hello everyone, my name is Uyên Saem. I'm really pleased to come here again in order to teach you a lot of grammar lesson. You know, my grammar lesson come out day to day, so don't miss it. Watch it every day. I try my best to tell you some more about grammar, like the for positive, negative question, it form, it usage, it's the difference between one to another, or something like that. Have you watched future form, the will and going to so far? Did you understand it then? You know it form and how to use it clearly, is it? In today's video, I'm going to teach you future form, will versus going to. Do you know the difference between will and going to? Okay, so look at the board with me. In order to distinguish will and going to, make sure that we have to learn its usage. So look at the board here. Will, your future forms, will versus going to. Will, or how many usage of will? Based on this, we have four usage of will. So how many uses of going to? Based on this, there are two uses of going to. Let's go with me. Well, will is used to express a future decision or intention made at the moment of speaking. This point, it means that you have no plan. Everything happens immediately at the moment of speaking. How about going to? Going to is used to express a future decision, intention, or plan made before the moment of speaking. In this point, it means that before you speak, you already plan to do anything. And then you just speak it out. It means everything was already planned before you speak. Yeah. Look at the example of win. I'll phone you back in a minute, so when you this sentence means you do not have any plan, you just say immediately. The phone ringing, I'll get it. The phone ringing, then I'll get it without any plans, and I go straight to answer to get it. How about going to, they are going to live in the USA, so living in the USA is not an easier one. So before going there, they have already planned to live there. So before the moment of speaking. So number one and number one here different. Will is mean that at the moment of speaking, while going to number one here is before the moment of speaking. Number two, will is used to express an offer. Will is used to express an offer here mean that you show your spontaneous decision. So no one made you help him or her, but you volunteer to do this by yourself. It is a spontaneous decision. You are really kind to him or her. For example, I carry your suitcase. Actually, the owner of the suitcase does not ask you to help her or him, but you the one who do it by yourself. Number three, will is used to express a future fact. A future fact here, it means that the speaker thinks that it is sure to happen in the future. For example, Sam will be certified next year. A future fact here, it is called the pure future or future simple. Right. Number four, will for prediction can be based more on an opinion than a fact. Yeah, so when you use will, it based more on opinion than a fact. For example, I don't think Sam will do well in his exam. And actually, it is just my thinking. How about going to? Going to number two is that going to is used to express when we can see or feel. Can see or feel now that something is certain to happen in the future. In this section, when you talk about going to, it means that it shows the evidence that present fact, it is present fact. Well, for example, look at the cloud, it's going to rain. So you can see it now, it's almost raining. It all, you know, the rain almost dropped now. It is called a present fact. It's based on evidence. Okay? Again, will is used to express a future decision or intention made at the moment of speaking, while going to is used to express a future decision, intention, or plan made before the moment of speaking. Number two, will is used to offer or to express an offer, going no offer. Number three, will is used to express a future fact. Actually, future fact here, it is called pure future or future simple. But while going is not that. Number four, will for prediction can be based more on an opinion than a fact. While going to is used to express when we can see or feel now that something is certain to happen in the future. It is a present fact or it based on physical evidence that you can see now it going to happen in the future. Okay, does it make sense, everyone? If you are not quite sure of any point, please write your comment. I try my best to reply to all of your comments. But don't forget to watch my video every day. Each video come out every day. If you miss one, you might find it difficult to understand because of everything chronological order. Anyway, thank you very much for watching my video. See you later. Bye bye.